Here is part of an interview with the subject just before LSD is to be administered.
My husband is an employee here at the VA, and he told me that they were looking for normal people, and I volunteered.
I see. Do you feel you're normal?
I hope I'm normal. I think so.
Well, a little while back, you took quite a series of psychological tests, and I can assure you that you're a very stable and well-balanced person as a result of the tests. And how do you feel about coming here and drinking this strange material?
I'm a little nervous, perhaps.
Well, I think that's normal. Well, I think it's time for you to have your lysergic acid. Drink this down, and we'll be back after a while and see how you're doing.
This is a glass of water, colorless, tasteless. It contains 100 gamma of LSD-25, 1/10 of a milligram, the equivalent of 1/600th of a grain. An ounce of this material will make 150,000 such doses. Let us observe the effect some 3 hours later.
Well, tell me.
Well, I just couldn't. I couldn't possibly tell you. It's here. Can't you feel it? This whole room, this, everything is in color, and I can feel the air. I can see it. I can see all the molecules. I'm part of it. I'm. Can't you see it?
I'm trying.
Oh, it's just like you're released or you're free or. I don't know how I can tell you.
How do you feel inside?
Inside. I don't have any inside.
Is it all one?
It would be all one if you weren't here, and if nobody else. Yes, everything is one. You have nothing to do with it. I am one with what I am. I can see everything in color. Everything. You have to see the air. You can't believe it. And the dimensions and all the prisms and the rays and everything coming down through you and moving.
What does this all mean to you?
I've never seen such infinite beauty in my life. It's like a curtain or a spider web. Can you see it? It's right here in front of me right now. Watch. No. Good heavens. You know what went through me? It passed right through me.
Could you feel it?
Me? I wasn't any me.
Is all this pleasant or unpleasant? Or aren't these the right words?
What seems pleasant or unpleasant? There isn't anything pleasant or unpleasant. It's too beautiful. It's how can you think and can't you feel it? Everything is so beautiful and lovely and alive. You shouldn't say anything about anything not being. This is reality. This is. If you look right over there, Are you looking? Can you?
Yes, what should I see?
I wish I could talk in Technicolor.
Or
let you see. Can you? Did you say you can see it?
No, I can't quite see it. Tell me about it.
I can't tell you about it. If you can't see it, then you'll just never know it. I feel sorry for you.
Now, Gerald, I know you have great personal experience with lysergic acid. What do you think of it?
To do that in 2 minutes, eternity in an hour. It's almost impossible, of course, as all the patients say, to describe it. You can only say it isn't, it isn't, it isn't. Trying to tell people what it is. Well, of course, I don't know any of our friends, Sid, that have taken it but haven't said this one thing in common. Well, I never knew anything like that in the whole of my life. And one or two people have said to me, I've said it to myself, that's what death is going to be like. And oh, what fun it will be.
How do you mean that?
Well, I mean that there are the colors and the beauties, the designs, the beautiful way things appear. People themselves, dull people that I thought dull, appear fascinating, interesting, mysterious, wonderful. But that's only the beginning. A man was saying it this afternoon who was taking it. Suddenly you notice that there aren't these separations. That we're not on a separate island shouting across to somebody else and trying to hear what they're saying and misunderstanding them. You know, you use the word yourself, empathy. This thing's flowing underneath. We're parts of a single continent. It meets underneath the water. And with that goes such delight. The sober certainty of waking bliss.